The National Legal Aid Bill was among the bills which were affected recently when the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Ulanya, threw out business which was left pending by the 10th Parliament. The Kumi Municipality Member of Parliament, Silas Aegon, has taken responsibility to return this bill to Parliament, which had earlier been moved by the former Gulu Municipality Member of Parliament, Leandro Kumakech. The bill seeks to provide for grant of legal aid services to poor and vulnerable persons.
The short title of this bill is the National Legal Aid Bill, National Legal Aid Act, and this will be 2021, and this is an act to help us consolidate and also update the law on legal aid in Uganda, and to make provision for the grant of legal aid services to indigent, marginalized, and vulnerable persons. To make provisions for eligibility for grant of legal aid.
There are many legal aid service providers that are providing legal aid services, but their work is scattered in different pieces of legislation. And it's not very structured, it's not very streamlined. So I think it's important for us as a country to have what we call a legal aid bill.
The bill grants every poor person a right to apply for legal aid services from any accredited legal and service provider, and also allows the beneficiary to make choice of the lawyer to represent them. It also intends to define eligibility.
If the law is made, it has three elements that we find very critical to the country. Number one, because it is structuring legal aid provision, there are many legal aid service providers that will emerge. Number two, because the law creates immunity to legal service providers, it is going to give them the impetus to work more. Number three, because the law council is coming in to regulate legal aid service providers, there is going to be more confidence from the public.
During the consultative meeting today, members of parliament challenged the government to take up its constitutional duty to provide legal aid services to the vulnerable poor, but not to leave it to the civil society organizations.
If we say there will be no financial implication, does it mean the funding to support the legal aid service provider will be purely from donors, no government fund included anywhere? Because this one, at the end of the day, the people will say, meaning the government is not interested in us, they aren't supporting us. So to me, I think there must be somewhere where the government has to come in and to provide the funds to support its people.
Council Tamale clearly mentioned Article 28, where government provides, is required to provide legal representation, which is a form of legal aid, but they only provide legal representation for poor people who are charged with capital offenses that attract either death or life imprisonment.
We are excluding government because as a private member, I'm not allowed to, but our issue now in terms of funding sources, we are looking at donors. There are people who are well-wishers for our communities who are indigent, who are marginalized, who are not able to pay for this cause. It's through grants from abroad. There are those who are able to. So it should come out through the law.
With 44 million people, 41% of Ugandans live in poverty and can hardly afford legal services. Lawmakers have hoped that this bill will amplify access to legal services to the vulnerable people and enhance development.
There is a category of people who are poor, who are vulnerable, who are not accessing justice for the simple reason that they don't have money. So this law makes a proposal to waive the filing fees. There are people who cannot access justice because they don't have filing fees. So we are talking about waiving the requirement for filing fees.
We intend to make sure that Ugandans are aware about this, so that, because even as we talk right now, there are service providers who have been helping with legal aid, for instance, a feeder. But if you ask me how many people, how many women, how many children out there have been aware about these services, most times when a matter requires a legal representation, most of our communities, people quail up because they do not have enough what information.
The bill shields vulnerable persons against the provision of paying costs in civil matters once cases are not decided in their favor. It also provides for waiver of court filing fees for the vulnerable people. Report by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.